I would have to say that, and it depends on how you characterize what happened, but the reality is that communities of color feel that justice does not exist in a universal way. And this is one example, one huge example of a tremendous tragedy that happens over and over again. Just a few days ago, a kid had a 12-year-old in Cleveland had a gun and was shot by a policeman. The gun happened to be a toy gun. Perhaps the policeman didn't know that, but they advanced and shot him. And there are several incidents where police are consistently, it feels, to communities of color, shooting them. So the question is, how do we address this as a society? And I think this is the pent-up frustration, not just in the African-American community, but if you look at demonstrations around our nation, New York City, Philadelphia, Boston, Los Angeles, just to name a few, but there were over 100 cities that had peaceful protest on last night, and many of those audiences or many of those who participated were white Americans, white young people.
If, however, the grand jury believed the version that the policeman who shot Mr. Brown has now given, and that his gun was being reached for, they may have reached the right verdict, mightn't they?
Well, certainly, that is really what the real question is. What is a little mysterious to me is very rarely do African-American young people confront police. In fact, 9 out of 10 instances, young people are running from police. So the version doesn't exactly add up to what was said. The main thing is the officer, one of the things I'd say was the officer was not cross-examined because his testimony was just accepted because he's an officer, as opposed to at least some level of cross-examination. My understanding is that did not occur. So at a minimum, there should have been cross-examination, which may, the result may have been the same, but that did not happen.